Hello everybody, welcome to my channel, Not Just a Pianist. As you may know, the 28th of September is Confucius' birthday. In Chinese culture, Confucius is considered as one of the greatest teachers in the world. And today I'm going to use this opportunity to visit my beloved piano teacher. His name is Max Odin A.M. He is 92 years old. I have to say, he is one of the most important person in my life. He is not only teaching me how to be a great pianist, but also a good person. So please join me today and have this room tour and house tour to visit my teacher. I can't wait to show my gratitude to my beloved teacher. Let's go. So now, my husband Aaron and I are at Mr. Max Odin and Miss Pamela Page's home now. We can have a short house tour. Both Mr. Max and Mrs. Pam are musicians and have been devoted themselves to music industry for 60 years. They retired 5 years ago. Mr. Max Odin is currently 92 years old. He was born in 1929, growing up in a beautiful island in Australia, Tasmania. His career has included all the music-related works you can imagine, such as choir master and chorale works, as well as teaching, administration, and serving as organist and conducting symphony band. He received several awards. One of his significant honors is that he was appointed a member of the Order of Australia AM. Both Max Odin and Pamela Page are brilliant musicians, and their dedication and love for music have been recognized. As you can see in the house, they don't only love music, but also appreciate arts. This couple live with us for sure, so envious.
Big one.
So you made it, right?
Yes, I did.
Yeah, I remember
you made it.
It's there.
And the one on the lift.
Miss Pamela Page has been painting for several years. Look at this room. Amazing.
Are you sure?
My darling?
Are you sure?
Yes, you can take one.
Wow!
Are you sure?
Too hard to choose. Too many choices.
Can I take this one?
Yes, probably.
I'm so lucky to get this cute painting. It's a gift from Miss Pamela. So thankful. Well, I will explain why I choose this painting in the end of this video.
I'm just enjoy doing them. I'm gonna put on the top of my piano. After me.
Now I'm going to present my musical work 2020 to my teacher. I have to admit that I'm kind of nervous.
Thank you.
structure.
There are two more sections in there. But I'm still, yeah.
That's structure. And you've got form.
Yes.
In there. So your choice of key, A minor?
Yes.
And then your modulate according to the dominant and dominant. But
yeah.
See, that's organizational. And you've got an organized approach to what you want to say.
Yes.
Music.
Yeah.
Your level in terms of tonality, there's no real differentiation or need for it.
Yes.
It's short enough to carry that sort of constant sound.
Yeah.
But also it can benefit by perhaps doing a repeat phrase, stuff like that. Certain compositions as a child.
Oh yeah, yes.
Do you remember it?
From four.
Wow.
I used to compose. I started playing it too. I wasn't taught.
Wow.
You don't remember any?
No, I remember the name of one of my compositions. It was Falling Leaves.
Pardon? That's pictorial.
Yes.
And
we had a lovely tree in the backyard, and in the autumn it used to drop a lot of leaves, and I think that inspired the composition when I was
so
a baby.
Many descending scales, descending phrases for falling leaves.
I can't remember what.
But you would have done that.
I would have. Anyhow. Well, I couldn't understand why keys were always black and white.
Yes.
Because they were a colour to me. F was green, G was red, A was blue.
Which is quite wrong, of course.
It was always colour, and I couldn't understand why it was black and white.
Do you have a particular bent for that?
I kind of understand what Pam is saying.
Did you have a colour for A minor, for example?
Yeah.
Rich. What's your name?
Pink
for A minor.
Really?
Oh.
I'm so in love with A minor.
A major is not lovely blue to me, but A minor would be still in the blue, but on a dull or so.
Oh, okay. I'm like pastel pink for A minor now.
Anyway, someday drop off from music. Some of them, they still think in a way that you have to be super, super good to win this competition, win that competition. And their students also follow their path. Win this competition, win that competition.
Mm-hmm.
But to me, I just wanted to make music as meaningful as possible.
Jenny Fleming has published a book of little pieces.
Yes.
In her, what is she? What did she do? Did she come to an age?
Yes.
Anyway, the celebration was held at the old conservatorium in South Brisbane.
Yeah.
And Jenny is one of my favourite students.
Yeah, you mentioned that to us before.
And she, along with people like yourself,
who've
got a character and want to express it. You know, I'm mentioning Mendelssohn. Because that was something in your character which you wanted to express.
I do.
Yeah.
And I want to go fast as well.
Yes, of course.
Yeah.
And I can understand that because we've all been through that stage.
Yes. I really want to show off my skills. I'll be honest with you.
Yeah. But it's necessary to show off when you're in a competition.
Yes.
Show what you can do, what you're capable of.
Yeah.
And if you don't do that, then you're not in the running. Why'd you go for it in the first place? But it's good, and I like competitions for that reason. It is a developing stage, something that most of competitors want to do, and that is play well, we make it a prize.
Yeah.
There are, I think, 50% of those people don't necessarily want to go into competitions without some objective. It's either win a prize or develop.
Yeah.
And that develop is the one that is the most important and useful one in the long term. So I can name people that have made it much higher than I have, but have grown up in the same atmosphere.
Yeah.
And that doesn't bother me at all.
Mm.
It's part of the system of development. Thank you.
in Japanese, there is a saying that better than 1,000 days of digital study is 1 day with a great teacher. And I'm so lucky that Mr. Max Odin is in my life, and I'm so proud to be a student. He made me who I am today, and I love what I do today. Now I'm a teacher as well. I would like to try my best to not only teaching people music, but also give them the direction to be better musicians. That's why I spend most of my time to teach and establish a program for younger generation and population, for babies to toddlers, rather than 1 hour piano students. But also, I have those students who's already teenagers. I wanted to give them a great direction and help them to be a professional musician and to pursue their professional career in the music industry. In the end of this video, I want to explain why I select this piece of artwork from my teacher's wife, Miss Pamela Page. This looks like a rainbow. It brights up our life, just like music. It's got different colors. And Miss Pamela Page also remind me that for music, it shouldn't be black and white. It should be different colors. Thank you for watching this special video today. And I wish every teacher in this planet around the world happy Teacher's Day. This must be the most rewarding job in this planet. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the like, share my video, and press the bell icon to get new videos from my channels. You can also follow me on the social below. I will see you next time.